So I am Cécile Le Gallaire. I'm a CNRS researcher working in at the University of Technology of Compiègne in a research lab that is named Biomechanics and Bioengineering. And I'm more specialized in liver tissue engineering. As I just said, my team is working in liver tissue engineering for two major applications. So, one is find ways to supply liver functions at the scale of the whole body. So that means I have a lot of cells available and highly functional for extracorporeal liver circuit implementation. And we have also another application dealing more with organ-on-chip technology. And in this field, we are interested in trying to rebuild some liver tissues for several applications. One of them is drug screening, but also try to find the best 3D organization for the cells so they can be really active in terms of functions such as albumin production or cytochrome activity or biotransformation. We know that the hepatic cells, they like to reorganize themselves together. And depending on the gel or the environment you are using, they can do it more or less easily. So that was maybe the first point in which we were interested in the biomimesis technology. But maybe the key point is that, as I said, we are using microfluidic devices. And so it's small bioreactors made of PDMS, in which we have specific channels, and usually we cultivate the cells in 2D, in this layer by layer, let's say, on the surface of the biochip. And including biomimesis in this biochip appeared interesting for us to see whether first the scaffold can really fill the whole culture section of the biochip, and then to see how the cells will reorganize in the system. So the idea was working with HCS Pharma was to implement the gel into the biochip, see first whether it would be possible, and then how the hydroscaffold will behave within this chip. And we performed the perfusion, we measured the pressure within the system, and we found it that the additional resistance that was created because of the presence of the gel was very low. So that means that there will be no high pressure in the system, and it's good for us because usually our cells do not like to be submitted to high pressures. So in our application for the liver, one of the key points was the perfusion, as I said before, but also the liver is really soft tissue. And we discovered recently that when we entrap the cells in different tissue, different scaffold with different stiffness, their behavior was quite different. So as the biomimesis scaffold is present really low, what we call mechanical properties. So it's as a gel, it's very soft environments. The Young modulus is quite low. So that means at least it's what we believe that the hepatic cells will be in a environment that is really close to what they can find in the native liver and native healthy liver. So it's what we postulate using biomimesis in the chips. And the interesting results, what we found up to now, is that the cells are able to reorganize in 3D. They form some kind of aggregate spheroids. And we know that in these conditions, that they are usually much more active than when they're isolated in a scaffold, for instance. So we did not go very far for the moment in the application. It was more feasibility assessments, but the first results are very good. And so the next step will be to switch from a cell line to other type of cells, such as primary cells or iPS, for instance. Would say yes. I mean, at least you should try. It's my opinion that there are many options now in tissue engineering and also combined with organ-on-chip technology. So there is no definitive answer, and I think it's really dependent of the cell type you are using. So in our case, I think it's at least we need to perform much more tests and to go on with the cell culture with biomimesis to make sure it's a good option, but it's still a good option at the moment. And for other cell type, you should just try, I would say.